ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 22nd பாசுரம். அங்கண்மா நியாலத்தரசர் அபிமான பங்கமாய் வந்து நின் பள்ளி கட்டிற்கீழே சங்கமிருப்பார் போல் வந்து தலை பெய்தோம் கிங்கிணிவாய் செய்த தாமரை பூ போலே செங்கண் சிறு சிறுதே எம்மேல் விழியாவோ திங்களும் ஆதித்யனும் எழுந்தார்போல் அங்கனிரண்டும் கொண்டு எங்கள் மேல் நோக்குதியேல் எங்கள் மேல் சாபமிழிந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். The fifth scene of Thiruppavai is the one in which Aandaal and her friends have reached Lord Krishna's room and are trying to wake him up from sleep so that he can come and listen to their needs and assist them to complete the Pavai Nombu. Nappinnai, Lord Krishna's consort, teaches these girls how to wake up Krishna. She tells them that if they call Krishna in a particular manner, then he will definitely get up. And Nappinnai's trick works. So by the end of the 21st Pasuram, the girls realize that the Lord is almost about to open his eyes. So now these girls, being real rasikas or fans of the Lord, they want to enjoy each and every movement of the Lord. So as the Lord opens his eyes, they want to enjoy every bit. So they are actually telling the Lord, or because they have the liberty, we can even say they instructed the Lord as to how he should open his eyes as he is getting up. And that is what this 22nd Pasuram is all about. In the last Pasuram, Aandaal and her friends ended by saying that they have come down to Krishna as if enemies would come after they lost a battle. They would come as Krishna alone is their refuge. And so also these girls have come having no other refuge other than Krishna. In this Pasuram, she again speaks about how they have come to him. She says that now we have come as kings to you. Like how the kings come and approach you, like that we have come. And how do the kings come and approach the Lord? It seems that the kings give up their ego and pride when they come to the Lord's sannidhi or temple. And thus we have also come. She says, Ankanma nyalattarasar abhimana bangamai vandhinin pallikattirkile. Ankanma nyalattarasar refers to the kings who rule over beautiful lands. Am means beautiful. Kanma nyalam refers to large areas of fertile land. Beautiful large areas of fertile land are ruled over by Arasar kings. And when they come to you, my Lord, how they come? Abhimana bhangamai. They come giving up their abhimana or ego. Vandhinin pallikattirkile. And they come and stand at your bedside, she says. Now, which kings is Aandaal talking about? Who came leaving their ego and pride to the Lord and stood by his bedside? For this, we go back to the Mahabharata and look at a story from there. It is said that it was decided that the Mahabharata war was going to happen between the Kauravas and the Pandavas. And both of them wanted to seek the help of Krishna. The Kaurava side unwillingly wanted to seek his help so that they don't have any blame to take on themselves that they have left out Krishna, and the Pandava's side very fondly wanted to take the help of Krishna. So as their representative, the Kauravas send Duryodhana to Dwaraka to meet Krishna, and the Pandavas send Arjuna as their representative to Dwaraka to meet Krishna before the war. Now, when both these kings come to Dwaraka, it seems Lord Krishna is sleeping. But the guards let both of them in because they were relatives of Krishna. Duryodhana's daughter was married to Krishna's son. So thus they became sambandhis, and so he was let in. And Arjuna was Krishna's aunt's son, his cousin. So he was also let in. Now, as soon as Duryodhana entered, he saw that Krishna was sleeping in a room in which there was a throne placed at his head side. And there was a small tripod stool placed at the foot side of the cot where Krishna lay. Duryodhana thought, I am the king of Hastinapura, the would-be king of Hastinapura. So I deserve to sit only on the throne. So thinking, he goes and sits on the throne, which is on the head side of Krishna's bed. A few minutes later, Arjuna walks in, and he doesn't sit on that tripod seat, which is still vacant. Instead, he stands by the feet of Lord Krishna, and he's admiring the beauty of the sleeping Lord. He feels very fortunate to be looking at the Lord like this, sleeping. Thus, he gave up all his pride and ego of being a king and did not sit down but stood looking at the beauty of the Lord. He realized that he was not as great as he thought, or the greatness that is attributed to a king is nothing as compared to the greatness of the Lord. So thus, he gave up all his ego and he stood by the bedside of the Lord. And then what happened? Then Lord Krishna woke up, and as soon as he woke up, obviously his eyes fell on Arjuna, who was standing in front of him. So he greeted Arjuna first. Duryodhana shouted from behind, saying that I was the one who came earlier. Then Krishna greeted him too and gave both of them a seat. And then he started inquiring as to on what purpose they had come. So both of them said that they came to seek help from Krishna for the Mahabharata war. Lord Krishna gave them two options. He said, one of you can have my fully equipped army known as Navakoti Narayana Sainya, and one of you can have me on your side, but I shall not take any weapon and fight. I will just be on your side. And the right to exercise option I shall give to Arjuna, says Krishna, because Arjuna is younger to Duryodhana, and the younger one always gets the chance to exercise an option. So by this rule, I would suggest that Arjuna should make a choice here. Now Duryodhana was troubled at heart, that he was worried if Arjuna chose the big army of Krishna, then he would be doomed. What would he do with this weaponless Krishna on his side? To add on, he would have to give him 1/2 kilo butter every day to keep him happy. So just this Krishna without weapons was going to be no use to Duryodhana. That's what he thought. So he wanted the Sainya or the army in his heart of hearts. So he was praying that Arjuna should not ask for the army. And it seems that the Lord answered his prayers, because Arjuna chose Krishna, the weaponless Krishna, over his big, fully equipped army. He made a choice of Krishna, and that is how Krishna came and fought on Arjuna's side, on the Pandava's side, and they won the war too, we know that. Now, just because this Arjuna gave up all his ego and came and stood by his side and made a choice to just have him, the Lord did what not for Arjuna and his side. He became a driver of his chariot, the Lord of Lords. He became a mere charioteer. And as a charioteer, he was taking care of the horses, giving them meals, cleaning them, taking away their dung, removing arrows from them. What not did the Lord bear just because somebody gave up his ego and sought him. So we girls, Krishna, have come like that Arjuna, who came as Abhimana Bhangamai. Like that we have come giving up our Abhimana or ego, and we are standing by your bedside. பள்ளிக்கட்டிற்கீழே சங்கம் இருப்பார் போல் வந்து தலை பெய்தோம். We have all come with a group and we are standing here. சங்கம் இருப்பார் போல். So we now request you to open your eyes and glance at us. Give your grace. How should you open your eyes? கிங்கிணிவாய் செய்த தாமரை பூ போலே. You must first open your eyes as if the opening is like the slit found in a kinkini. Kinkini refers to small beads present on anklets, the neck, the leg wear of women. Anklets generally have small beads with a mouth-like opening, slit-like opening. That is called kinkini. So Andal is saying you have to open your eyes first slightly like the kinkini. You know why? Because we want to experience every bit of this opening. We don't want to miss a single moment, a single microsecond. So please open slowly first. Kinkinivai cheda tamarai poopole. And then slowly open your eyes as if a lotus would blossom. So we want to see that beauty. Sengan chiru chiru deyemmel viliyavo. Like this, the lotus-like eyes should slowly blossom, chiru chiru de, and they should come and shed their glances on us. Emmel viliyavo. And then once the eyes are widely open, they would look like the sun and the moon. Thingalum adithyanum elundar pol. We have seen the Lord has both the qualities of the sun and the moon on his face, as we saw in the first pasuram. So also his eyes have the same qualities, it seems. When the eyes look at the enemies of devotees, they are like the scorching sun. And when they look at the devotees, they are cool and pleasant as the moon. So that beauty we want to enjoy, O Lord, she says. Amkanirandum kondu engal mel nokkudiyel. She says, with these beautiful eyes, am means beautiful, kannirandum kondu, with these two beautiful eyes, yem kan mel nokkudiyel. Please look into our eyes, she's saying. Because it seems it's very important that the bride and the groom look into each other's eyes before they make a choice that they are going to become bride and groom. Let me explain. There is a practice of the boy and the girl meeting first. In case of arranged marriages, they are made to see each other, and that aspect of seeing each other is called pon paakaradu or ladki dekhna, as they say in Hindi. So it's very important that such a thing happens, because the boy and the girl have to look at each other, and it is said that when they look at each other, if things are going to work out between them, if they are going to proceed with the marriage, then there is a kind of friendship that happens between the pupils of the boys and the girls' eyes. This is called as Tara Maitri. So Tara means pupil of the eye, and Maitri is friendship. So only when a friendship happens between the pupils of the two eyes, that is of the eyes of the boy and the girl, then a good marriage is possible. That is why this aspect of looking at each other is very, very important. And looking at each other in person is very important. With all the technological advancement, we tend to see our life partner for the first time over social media or through Skype or WhatsApp or whatever. But the best would be to have personal looking at each other, so that marriages become successful. And this is something which is conveyed by Purvacharyas too. Swami Deshikan says, Tara Maitrim Dadhanaya Karune. It seems such a friendship of the pupil exists between Lord Srinivasa and his consort Daya Devi. That is Goddess Lakshmi personified as mercy or compassion. So that is very important, and Aandaal is asking for this pupil friendship. That is why she is saying, Amkan irandum kondu yemkan mel nokkudiyel. With your two beautiful eyes, please look into our eyes. So that the understanding between us will be perfect. And if you do so, O Lord, then what will happen to us? We will be completely washed clean of our sins and curses, she says. Engal mel shabam ilinde lorembavai. She says, all the curses on us will be gone. Now, there are two things. One is sin and one is curse. If one commits a sin, then there is something which can be done to do away with this sin. There can be an atonement to the sin, a prayaschitta to papa. But if one receives a curse, then there is nothing like atonement. One has to go through the effect of the curse. So there's nothing that can nullify or neutralize a curse. But, O Lord, your glances can make curses completely inoperative. So please cast your glances on us, says Aandaal. The Lord alone, Lord Narayana alone, is capable of doing away with curses or nullifying curses. He has proved it more than once. There was a stone and it was under a curse. It was actually a girl and had become a stone because of a curse. Who was this? It was Ahalya Devi. And the moment Lord Rama set foot on the stone became the girl, the lady Ahalya. So just by the touch of his holy feet, a person was redeemed of her curse. Similarly, when Lord Shiva was cursed to have a skull stuck to his hand, it was a drop of blood from the chest of Lord Narayana that saved Shiva from this curse. So, something associated with the Lord can redeem a person of his curse. And so, O Lord, we pray to you that your glances may fall on us and redeem us from any curse that we may be suffering from. Many a times, we are not even aware that somebody has cursed us. But the curses do take effect at times. So, in order to do away with any unknown curse that might have fallen on us, we pray that your beautiful glances fall on us. As the girls request so beautifully, the Lord actually listens to them and opens his eyes first as Kinkini, then as Tamarai the lotus, and then he looks at them with eyes that were like the sun and the moon, and the girls are extremely happy to look at this beautiful form of the Lord and very, very satisfied to receive his glances on them. Now next, what the girls are going to do, we shall wait and watch till tomorrow.